Well, a team of researchers believes they can use all that heat and humidity to create clean energy. Gordon Severson joins us now with that story. Hi, Gordon.
Hi, Julie. Yeah, a research team from the University of Massachusetts Amherst published a study earlier this month that is getting a lot of attention online. They argue the moisture in the air has small amounts of energy in it, and by creating a very thin layer of material, we can collect it and generate power.
Drawing energy from humidity may sound like something out of a science fiction movie, but at one point, so is drawing energy from the sun or the wind, and now it's everywhere.
The base science makes sense. I think it's viable.
Nina Axelson is the president of Grid Catalyst, a Minnesota group that helps green energy startups grow and enter the marketplace. She says what this research team in Massachusetts is doing with humidity is very interesting.
So for me, it's exciting. I'm not quite at the point yet to say this is going to be the game changer.
That's because right now, Axelson says it's just an idea. Here's how it works. The researchers say, think about a cloud in the sky. It's nothing more than a massive grouping of water droplets. Each of those droplets has a charge, and when conditions are right, you get lightning. These researchers believe that by creating a very thin material with nanopores, tiny holes that are 1,000 times thinner than a human hair, theoretically, we could move water droplets in the air through this thin material and capture their energy.
They've only done things at this really small scale, so some of that big challenge in emerging tech is how do you move something from idea to prototype to scale to deployment?
Even if this idea works, Axelson says it could be 5 to 10 years before we have machines that can power our homes with humidity. But even if this idea doesn't work out, she says it will likely inspire others to create the next big thing.
It's never been a more exciting time for energy discovery, invention, innovation. The clean tech landscape is so cool right now.
Now, one of these researchers on this team recently told the Washington Post that in theory, they should be able to stack a billion of these layers of thin material all together. It would be the size of a refrigerator, and it would be able to generate enough electricity to power most of your home. So in the next couple of years, we'll see if that actually happens, Julie.